We already know that Sheena Ringo is a massive, massive star of the Japanese music scene, and also she's a big favourite of the musos. With work along with things like Tokyo Jihen, she has always had these really interesting instrumental arrangements and really cool things going on. But here she is doing a collaboration with NOCCHI from Perfume. I hope I'm pronouncing her name right. I've never actually said her name out loud before. It is NOCCHI, right? I should probably read the hiragana. Anyway, the thing is, they're doing a collaboration together. And the reason why I think this is so exciting is that NOCCHI and Perfume are like the absolute opposite in so many ways. I mean, they're one of those groups who, if you're into Japanese music, you just have to accept that they are also absolute legends, Perfume. But when we think of Perfume, we think of stage shows, you know, a lot of choreography, a lot of the time sort of vocoder work, things where they're not so much singing directly as it's more about the dance and the stage show. But this is not too, you can't take away from the fact that they are still legendary for what they've achieved. They've entertained so much, they've taken their music abroad, they've got so many famous hits. And the truth is that despite the sort of audio aesthetic of everything, I think the three of them can still sing and dance. Well, they can obviously dance very well, but they can sing very well. And so I'm kind of excited to hear what happens when you bring together these two opposites. And I also love the fact there is this mutual respect between them. But we've got two legends coming together here. We've got NOCCHI of Perfume and obviously Sheena Ringo. I would say Sheena Ringo of Tokyo Jihen, but the people would be like, no, no. Which one is bigger, Sheena Ringo or Tokyo Jihen? I think Sheena Ringo. Oh, that's a controversial remark to start this off with, isn't it? All right, anyway, so we're going to get into this. We're going to check this out. I'm personally excited. I have to say, I am. We've done three songs so far from this collaboration album, which I think is just such a cool idea. I have said, and I am somewhat prepared for the fact that the songs I've heard so far, it kind of feels like an evening with Sheena Ringo, where the songs are more Sheena Ringo biased. They're written by her, as far as I'm aware, and it's kind of her doing songs that lean slightly towards the collaborating artist rather than celebrating the differences. It's more Sheena Ringo songs that are designed to better suit the collaborating artist. Some of those work really, really well, like the Atarashi Gakko one, which had me genuinely surprised, and then there's some where they kind of work okay, like the Daoko one, where I was kind of hoping that would be something a little bit more to give Daoko a little bit more of her own ability to sort of showcase what makes her so cool. But in this case, I really don't know what to expect. I'm just excited. Again, it's it's a relatively tight song at 4 minutes, probably the longest of the ones we've heard so far, but let's jump in. Enough waffle. Sheena Ringo and NOCCHI from Perfume. This is gonna be fun. Well, the look immediately is very different. It's not like on the stage show like the previous ones. Unless they're heading to the stage. They are. Alright. Okay, it's definitely got a little bit of the Perfume feel for, well, I was gonna say funk, but then again, both of them are famous for funk. But it's more dancey in a sort of a Perfume-y way. It is true that these Sheena Ringo songs benefit so much from the really detailed musicianship. The feel on the drum kit is brilliant. But I'm loving the way their voices work together as well.
Yeah.
What is going on here? Is this like the Anger Issues song? I'm loving the energy behind this. It's got a real feel of purpose to this song. Yeah, I love the whole build up and everything. Okay, I think we're gonna get a big payoff at the end. Well, that wasn't fair. Okay, again, like with some of the other songs, very sudden ending. Okay, so this one, yeah, I can see why a lot of people were intrigued by this, and it's and had been mentioning this one to me before, and it's not just simply because of the fact that the song itself obviously has a lot of star power behind it, because the other ones have as well, but this one is, there's a feeling that there's a little bit more purpose, a little bit more effort, a little bit, something a little bit more deliberate about this one. And that maybe comes across partly in the video as well. Actually, definitely comes across in the video as well. But I really like the whole feel of this. I like the fact that it kind of had like a little bit of a tough, rebellious feel to it, but it was done with a slightly tongue-in-cheek aspect as well. I've often said there's something a little bit cringy about when you get songs that try to be tough but they don't have any self-awareness. I'm kind of looking at Blackpink kind of things. But when you get something like this where it's got a little bit of attitude but it actually carries it with a certain element of class as well, that's really cool. And I like this here, that so many things about what makes this song what it is and this video what makes it what it is really cool. Now obviously we're talking about two very famous vocalists, and vocally they come across well here. Obviously there is a difference. I think that Nocci's voice, I don't know how to describe it. I don't want to say it's the more normal voice, because that sounds like really being quite underwhelming in my opinion of it. You know, it's just saying, oh, it's normal, but she's definitely got a more conventional singing voice, whereas Sheena's got a little bit more of a gritty, jazzy quality, if you like. However, I think that they actually held up really well against each other, and it was one of those songs where the differences between their voices helped the song. It helped the song sound thicker. It helped, like, give it more, you know, more body to a song when you've got two voices who can play off of each other. And it felt like as they went backwards and forwards, their two voices played off each other, but neither sounded weaker. They just sounded different. And that is a really good thing to have in a duet. And then when they were singing together, their voices matched beautifully. So it just was one of those ones where I guess you can't really imagine what their voices are going to sound like together until you hear it. And when you hear it together, it's like, yeah, they work really well as a duet. Musically, again, very much in keeping with what we'd said about the previous ones in this collection of songs. Somewhat for the best and for the worst. For the best is the fact that it's got that fantastic instrumentals going on there. It just gives it so much detail, so much life. You know, we're used to hearing funky stuff in Perfume songs as well as in Sheena Ringo songs. But here, just having that extra touch of like the drum kit just being beautifully played and all of those aspects, the electric keyboard. And I always forget the name of that electric keyboard that gives that sort of Stevie Wonder-esque sound. But that was in the background there, sort of analog style electric keyboard. All those little things that gave it so much life and personality, and I often say like a tangibility to the musicianship. It felt real. It felt like a live band. Yeah, that was all there. But on the slightly more negative side, obviously saying that, you know, sonically it didn't really feel like it was doing anything that was, you know, it felt safely within the wheelhouse of all the other songs that have come out of this album. It wasn't like it was reaching to do something totally of its own. It felt like it was very much, all of these songs feel like they're very much a chip off the same block, you know, they're taken from a very similar concept. Where this song, I think, had a lot on its side was the build-up. So not every song has to build to a crescendo. I don't think that's necessarily true, but when you've got a song that has a slightly dramatic edge to it, like this one does, you want it to feel like it is building to something because, you know, in the same way the video has got an almost cinematic quality, the song's kind of got a quality, like there's a feeling of, you know, a slightly, well, again, a cinematic quality. And so you want it to feel like it builds up to something. And this does, you know, that bridge was beautiful, building it up. And then the final chorus comes in. It's a catchy chorus as well. I didn't even really address that, but the chorus is catchy in this song. Da, 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 da. Yeah, who's not going to enjoy it? It's like, it's simple, but it's catchy. And yeah, I really like that side of it. Now, the final thing I will say, I wanted to circle around to it, because it's maybe not the most important issue, but it's certainly one that is worth talking about in regards to this song, is the video. I thought the video was a ton of fun. Now, the very first scene was the one of Shiringo getting off of the motorbike with the big, like, fur coat looking thing. And I gotta be honest, my initial reaction when I saw that was like, I hope we don't go too far down this route, because it looks... It, at first, this is my initial thought, don't judge me on this, my initial thought was, oh god, let's not go in a cringy direction, let's not go too try hard here, it looks a little bit try hard, you know. This is another thing, actually, not to dunk on K-pop too much, but again, you get K-pop videos so often, there's just like someone's wheeled in a motorbike and there'll be people sitting on motorbikes and stuff trying, and half the time it looks really cringy, you're like, are you sure? That motorbike might not have a fucking working engine in it, you know? But in this case I was like, okay, where's this gonna go? But then as it developed, just the sense of fun came in, and there was a little bit, again, a little bit of swag to it. I was gonna say, actually, one of the mental notes I was making is it kind of gave me a feeling of West Side Story, but then I realized I've never seen West Side Story. I just know it from like stereotypical, like, we've all seen like clips and stereotypes and like pastiches of it before, so I've never actually seen it before, but it's that vibe of it's like a sort of a little bit gang competition, but it's all done in a sort of slightly twee musical fun sense. So it was like that. It was like, had a bit of swagger, but it was a lot of fun. And I was really surprised with the bit where Sheena knocks Notchi down. I was like, oh my god, I can't believe they put that in the video. And I was fully expecting, because you get the bit where she's lying down and Sheena goes over to her. And I was thinking, this is absolutely a, here's a movie I have seen. This is a Chris Tucker Friday moment. Just if Sheena had just leant over and gone, you got knocked the fuck out, I would have been, okay, there we go. It was just fun. I mean, the fact there's so many fun things to talk about this, I enjoyed it. It was a good giggle. Yeah, again, I go back to my original point. If I was judging each of these songs without the building knowledge I have of the album, I would argue that yes, I would have liked to have heard it do something that played a little bit more towards showing, you know, two combining worlds. I always love that when collaborations do that. But as this type of collaboration, one which is more about, you know, an artist being, you know, Notchi being brought onto the main artist, in this case, Sheena's song, yeah, this is great. It has that funky aspect that gives something that will definitely be appealing to fans of Perfume who like that sort of dancey music. Definitely has that. It maintains all the qualities that we've said from previous songs on this album. It feels like one of the, if not the most purposefully written of all the album songs so far. It definitely feels like it builds towards something and it has a direction. It doesn't feel like it meanders. It feels like it's really going towards something. And it's got a fun video that works well for it. Yeah, I enjoyed this a lot. I thought this was great. So those are my opinions. As always, get in the comments, tell me what you think. And until I hopefully see you very soon in Japan for the next one of these. For now, ciao, ciao.